Good evening, everyone. So today we will study the first learning outcome for administrative systems. So the main objective of this is to understand how a framework of integrated systems impact the administrative performance of organizations. So the objective behind studying this concept is that how the administrative systems are associated with the core business functions of a company. So in the first unit, we will explain the contribution an integrated framework of systems makes to efficient and effective administrative performance. Basically, how the administrative systems contribute towards performance. Then next, we will study the potential drawbacks to systems in an organizational context. And third outcome is to evaluate an integrated framework of systems. So this is basically related to the dynamics of the different functions of a system and how these impact the organization's performance. So first of all, we will study what is the meaning of an integrated framework. So an integrated framework means the organization's data and its applications, its hardware and software, all are integrated to provide the business with an interface so that they can carry out their normal activities. So it can be, the integration can be within an enterprise or with external systems. So an integration framework is very crucial for managing the movement of data between applications and organizations. So in today's business environment, data is the most critical element. So if you see organizations such as Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, all these are dependent on data. And therefore, data management becomes one of the key aspects in any organization. So the box, if you see below, that represents a core and comprehensive integrated framework within an organization. So it consists of the different business aspects such as operations, the reporting, the compliance, the control environment, the risk assessment, basically all the activities that an organization carries out. So the framework is a holistic perspective to ensure that all the different activities of an organization are covered. So it reflects the close interrelationship between control objectives and components of organizational structure. So what is the contribution of an integrated framework to effective administrative performance? So now, as you must be aware that almost all the organizations are dependent on information systems. So a few examples which I can give is like, for example, accounting software such as Tally, or probably checking mails and reporting dashboard. So all these come under integrated framework of systems. But the important point to notice is that all of these systems, they cannot work in isolation. So they have to interact with each other so that information is exchanged between the different employees and the different stakeholders of the organization. So the employees rely like usually on information systems to complete their daily activity. Like gone are the days when employees used to work on pen and papers, like mostly systems now. Even in core manufacturing organizations, if you like if you can understand, like most of them are done using production automation and automation systems, where the employees or the line managers, they generally have to specify the dimensions of the product, and then a batch processing in the batch processing the products are manufactured. So the core reason behind embracing information systems is to increase productivity, profits, and save costs. So productivity understood, profits, that is again dependent on how the systems are effective and contribute towards organizational strategy. and saving costs. So this can be a slightly controversial term because many of the academic literature have pointed out that organizations, they can spend a huge amount of money, but they are not able to fully utilize the potential of the information systems. So see, one of the main reasons is that most of the systems, they work in isolation. So there is no centralization of information systems or a distributed architecture where all the employees and all the managers and the senior management are connected, and the information systems, they process the relevant data to each stakeholders. So therefore, if the systems are not integrated, it may be difficult for employees to access information from other departments. So for some of the reasons, it may be due to security, or some of the reasons it can be due to the lack of adequate integration framework. So the first thing we need to understand, the concept behind information systems, is information technology. What is the driving force behind the information systems? So information technology is defined as a set of activities that are related to computer systems. So this can be either hardware, software, the integration system. So basically the entire package is known as information technology. So it covers across different cycles of development, implementation, maintenance, and then technology refresh. So most of the organizations, they make use of IT mostly to enhance the process and activity. So one should remember that IT itself is not the main business. It is a catalyst to the business. So it assists the business to function effectively. So some of the main benefits are like cost reduction, expedited decision making, and improved productivity. You may often come across the term of information systems. So information systems is also similar to, is also almost used interchangeably with information technology. However, information systems can also be exclusively used only for the the software side of it. So basically the flow of information, the use of user interface. So it comprises of the information technology infrastructure, the data, the application systems, and personnel that adopt the IT and use it for business purposes. So again, the main idea is to integrate the information technology and information systems within the organizational culture. So all the employees should be using the information systems, and they must be skilled enough to use these systems for the full advantage to the organization. So next thing is systems integration. So in the previous slides, we discussed the importance of an integrated framework and how it is very important for a system to be integrated. So the organizations, they spend a lot of money in integrating systems. So why is it important? So this is because the information can flow seamlessly. So I can give you one example of supply chain. So there you have the production, the logistics, the warehousing, and the distribution, and the movement of goods, all are integrated. So why is it important? First of all, it helps the managers to make decisions. So basically they can understand the goods are at so and so destination, so that they can estimate by when it will reach the final destination, and then they can accordingly inform the customer or give an expected delivery date. So that is one of the importance of systems integration. Now, systems integration is achieved only by the support of various factors. First of them is the top management support and commitment. So what does it mean? So generally, it is said that if the top management spends money and they expect the middle level managers to implement the systems, it is not always possible. most of the projects, they lead to failure. So the involvement of the top management, such as reviewing the progress, removing any hurdles for the project, or talking to different stakeholders for the use of the systems, such as if the use of system, I can give you an example, like if an automobile manufacturer wants to communicate with the supplier and integrate the systems for the procurement, the top management support is very important, as they will talk to the suppliers, they will convince them to come on board a common system. So that way the top management is very effective, and when they continue the their support, and when they inform the employees about the strategy and why it is important for looking out for new systems and the systems integration, then they can motivate the employees, and the employees will also have lesser resistance to change. That availability of financial resources, this is absolutely important. However, organization must also evaluate the extent to which financial resources are required. So many of the resources may go unwasted, wasted. So for example, if an organization, they want to develop a new software, but they have the option of either procuring the hardware and hosting on that, or looking for an option for hosting on the cloud. So if they procure the hardware and they procure high specifications, but they are unable to utilize that, so that means most of the financial resources are wasted. So therefore, an evaluation of the systems integration should be carried out. Then there should be a clear vision for systems integration. That means which systems will be integrated, what is the objective, what are the outputs that are expected from a system. Then adequate vendor support. So this is the responsibility of the organization to evaluate the vendors, the types of packages that they are offering, whether they are in line with the expectations of the organization, and they can help in improving the business processes. So this is very important to maintain communication with the vendor, or carry out a discussion before a decision on procuring the IT software and hardware is done. And then finally, the organization also has to make preparations for training of its own users, for its own employees who have to run the systems, who have to use the systems. And there should be a clear allocation of responsibilities for these employees. Now, systems implementation. So systems implementation basically refers to the implementation part. That means after the procurement is done, and then the use of, the implementation part, when the system has been new and it is being explained to everyone in the organization. For this, there is a design phase, there is a development phase, and then there is a testing phase. All these phases, it is very important for the employees to be involved with the vendors who are providing the solution, so that the requirements of the organizations are adequately met. So what are the key factors that can influence systems integration? So one of them is communication. So communication between vendors, communication with the top level management, all these are very important to review whether the systems integration is being carried out in the right way, whether the organization's strategy is being converted into the systems, so that all the business processes are aligned in that way. Then there is the importance of change management, like how will the organization transition by using this system. So this may involve like participation of the employees, identifying change agents, and then emphasizing on the importance of the system. Then lack of understanding. So in many cases, when the employees, they do not understand the implications of the change, they may often resist, or they may often create a negative environment. So this can be avoided by continuously speaking with the employees, making them understand about the vision of the organization. Then exploration of new technologies, like whichever technology is fit for the purpose of the organization, and then finally training and improvement. So what are the potential drawbacks of systems in an organizational context? So the first of the drawbacks is the rapid social and technological change. So like 20 years back, people used to work in office and then they used to come back at home. There were no smartphones. There were TV was there, but only it was limited to few channels. So there was a set lifestyle for the people. They never used to carry the work home. So, but now if you see most of the people, in fact, everyone is always hooked to a smartphone. Employees, they work from office, they bring a laptop, they work from home. So that is one of the main drawback that the society has seen because of the technological changes. And this has impacted everyone, all the office. In fact, people who are like 20 years ahead of us in the higher level, in the senior management, because they have to stay updated about the changes, or even if the new joinees, they also have, like, they willingly, they want to connect to the technology all the time. So that is one of the drawback. Then the second drawback is that leaders always face the challenge of deriving, benefits of the system in terms of business process reengineering. So like if they have spent a huge amount of money in the systems, but employees are using Facebook or WhatsApp on their office system, so that leads to a loss in productivity. So that is itself is a challenge for the leaders to encourage the employees to use the system for office purposes and improving the efficiency of the office. Then the uniting a few standards to a single management system. So there are many standards which can be followed across by different organizations. For example, if an organization wants to integrate data with another department, so there can be different standards. The other department may not have proper data quality, so integration can be a challenge. So these are the potential drawbacks when the entire information system is not conceptualized or a transformational change is brought about. Now, next we look into the evaluation of an integrated framework system. So what is important over here? So if you see, enterprise resource planning has become one of the widely used software across all organizations. So it offers the integration of the different business processes such as sales, production, human resources, finances, purchasing. So at a single interface, you get all the different modules of your business. So, and then you can give access to the different employees based on their department. So through the use of the ERP systems, so some of the ERP systems are SAP, Oracle, Microsoft, all these, they offer ERP systems. So the data can be shared, the information and knowledge can be put in a single repository where the employees can access these. And critical business processes or even the mass processes can be automated to reduce human intervention and improve the quality as well as the efficiency of processes, and generate and access information in real time environment using a single database. So the enterprise resource planning systems, they offer all these advantages. Now, one of the main challenges is that since these systems are complex, it becomes difficult to include all the requirements and difficult to capture everything for an organization. For example, the ERP systems are generally developed, or the product is being sold for a generic industry. Perhaps they might have customized for a few industries, but if a company has operations across multiple business verticals, the ERP system may not be appropriate. That means they might have to build a new system, which again is very cumbersome and time taking, and they are not even sure whether the system will live up to its expectation. So therefore, the ERP systems, before taking a decision on implementing these, it becomes important to analyze the requirements which can be met by the ERP systems and interact with the vendors whether they can customize the system to meet other requirements. So now we look into the example of office automation as an example of integrated framework. So in an office automation system, we have the global processes such as the sales, marketing, the payroll, the HR, and then there are individual processes. For example, in a food processing industry, in a food processing organization, the logistics or the supply chain, and then there are systemic processes. So what is required is a confluence of all these factors, and the system should be able to meet all these requirements. So some of the tools which are used with the office automation system are basically your desktop or laptop, which is integrated to your printers, the scanners. And then you have, in terms of software, you have the like your ticket booking systems, you have a customer support, you have you can see your engaged activities, you can see your dashboard. So these are the few functionalities that are important in office automation. So it ranks as one of the better resources for enhancing competitiveness. So office automation system is used by almost all the offices. For if you see, for even small and medium scale enterprises, they are using this office automation system. So it helps in information processing, it helps in communication, and then for the individual processes, whether it is global processes or systemic processes. So it brings about integration across all these aspects. So the office automation system, it is a complex system, no doubt, but once it has been developed, it can meet the requirements of the business. So it integrates four main domains, which are information technology, the office processes, the social factors, and the office systems. So a confluence of all these factors is what makes it successful. So that is all for the time being. So in case if you have questions, you can email me, and I'll be very happy to support.